Hi, hello and welcome. Microbe Hunter here today. And today I'm going to show you some algae that I found in my glass jar standing in front of my window for a couple of months. I left it there. And those algae, they look pretty, but they can be a significant problem if too many of them start to grow in ponds and on lakes. Because what they sometimes do is they form so-called algae mats, like you can see over here, and they cover the complete surface of the water, and therefore the plants that live in the water further down in the pond, they don't get enough light. And those algae mats, they can also be another problem for boats, for example, that might get entangled in those algae and so on, and they also don't look very pretty. Well, when I put those algae under the microscope, I did not only find a whole bunch of ciliates and rotifers, but also, surprise, a microscopic mite. So this kind of shows that the algae is also the habitat, the place where also many other animals, microscopic animals, are able to live. When too many algae start to grow, then this can indeed be a problem for the pond. Of course, the algae doing photosynthesis, they produce a lot of oxygen. Of course, that's good, but only up to a point, because when they grow too quickly and too much of them, sooner or later, they will die off and they will start to decompose. And when this happens, the bacteria start to increase in numbers, and then the oxygen concentration in the pond drops very quickly, and this can cause or be the cause for the death of a pond. This is referred to as eutrophication, and happens especially if there is too much fertilizer introduced into the pond. For example, if there are runoffs of water from agricultural fields and so on, they collect in the pond, and then this promotes the growth of these algae and ultimately also the death of the pond. Some of the cells that you see over here, they seem to be cut open and the cell contents are spilling out. The reason is when I took out those filaments from my jar, I had to cut them off using a scissor, and this caused some of the cells, of course, to break open and to spill the contents out. Those algae are, of course, a good place for Vorticella to attach to, and this is one of those nice, beautiful specimens that I found. And being a heterotroph, those Vorticella, of course, consume a large amount of oxygen as well, oxygen that the algae and other water plants provide. I think that essentially those algae are very worthwhile, a very worthwhile specimen to be observed under the microscope. And if you do a little bit of time lapse, something that I have not done right now, is then you can also see sometimes the chloroplasts, which are the green dots inside the cells, move around. So there is quite a bit of biological activity going on, and those algae are indeed responsible also for a very large percentage of our Earth's oxygen. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye bye.